Welcome to Miss Grand International 2016 Beauty Pageant. The beauty pageant that is regarded as one of the best three world-class beauty pageants of the world. And tonight, we will meet over 76 beautiful ladies from all over the world in the sleepless city of colorful lights and the world-leading capital city of entertainment, Las Vegas, USA.
Elizabeth Parker, and welcome to Las Vegas, USA! And here are our contestants from all around the world!
Australia, England, Berlin, now Estonia, Ghana, Serbia, India. gentlemen, and welcome to Miss Grand International 2016, live from the Westgate International Theater, Las Vegas, Nevada, USA. Now please give another round of applause to our 76 contestants from around the world. Now it seems like we have some of the best fans in the house. Who are we rooting for tonight? I heard some Philippines fans in here. Did I hear Jamaica over here? Woo! What about Brazil? Mexico? USA? Man, oh man. We have a live crowd tonight, and tonight we are searching for our new Miss Grand International 2016. Now, who do you think it will be? We're all gonna find out together later tonight. But up next, we find out who the top 20 finalists are. So don't go away.
Brought to you by Muang Thai Life Assurance Public Company Limited. Brought to you by Gamon Hospital.
Welcome back to Miss Grand International 2016's final night. Now, the first little winner for tonight is the Best National Costume Award, which was presented on October 16th at the Fremont Street Experience here in Las Vegas. The winner is Indonesia. Let's give Miss Indonesia another round of applause. Yes. Now, for a very exciting moment, we are ready to announce our top 20 final contestants. In no particular order, we have Jamaica. Bahamas. Let's hear it for Thailand. Ukraine! Let's hear it for Spain! Any anybody here from Mexico? Portugal. Let's hear it for Venezuela. Next, we have the United States of America. Let's hear it for Malaysia. Next, we have Cuba. Let's hear it for Peru. Next we have Australia. Give it up for Vietnam. Show some love for Puerto Rico. Next we have Indonesia. Make some noise for Tahiti. Three names left, who will they be? Next up, let's hear it for Wales. Two more, let's hear it for Oh, hold up the signs. Philippines. Yeah. last, but certainly not least, let's hear it for Macau. Congratulations, ladies, and thank you to all the rest. All of you are absolutely gorgeous. And of course, congratulations to all the beautiful ladies in the top 20. Thank you all. Now, I would like to introduce our 7 judges for tonight. Now, these are the people responsible for scoring our contestants and choosing the next Miss Grand International. It's certainly going to be tough work for them tonight. The first judge is Mr. Gino Lafrit, president of Westgate Las Vegas Resort and Casino. Please stand up and give us a wave. Yes, yes, a round of applause. Show some love, people. Next up, we have Miss Jenna Lee Chaparro, Miss Grand International 2013. Next, we have Miss Teresa Chavisut, Vice President of Miss Grand International Organization. And next to her, we have Mr. Ron Futrell, TV journalist and reporter. Next, we have Mr. John Lydell from New Dream Fashion Media Group, Las Vegas. Next, we have Mr. Ricardo Laguna, the BMX star. Let's show Ricardo some love, people. And last but not least, we have Mr. Phil Froelich, Vice President of Western Region Westgate. And last, but not least, Mr. Nawat Itzara Brasil, the president of Miss Grand International. Now up next, we'll see all the ladies in swimwear. So please, stay tuned.
Brought to you by MGI Swimwear, Lenny Sa Clinic.
International 2016 live from Westgate International Theater, Las Vegas. Now at this moment, we are ready to present our top 20 contestants in the new swimsuit collection by MGI Swimwear, appropriately entitled the Showgirls Collection.
She's with the band. fasten your seatbelts and make sure your champagne glasses are empty. We are now approaching the runway, so get ready for takeoff.
Please. Please.
Australia.
Please enjoy the swimsuit competition of Miss
Australia is 27 years old and she's graduated with a master's in pharmacy. Her hobbies include dancing, singing, writing, and yoga. Bahamas is 24 years old and she's a student of psychology. Her hobbies include flag football, reading, and traveling. Accounting and finance. Her hobbies include dancing. Indonesia is 21 years old and she is part of a medical faculty since 2012. Her hobbies include traveling and modeling. Jamaica. Jamaica is 25 years old and she is a fitness trainer as well as a professional model. Macau is 21 years old and she is a professional model. Her hobbies include working out, meditation, reading, and cooking. Malaysia is a 25-year-old doctor. Her hobbies include dancing. Mexico. Castle is a 25-year-old fashion designer. Her hobbies include painting, exercising, and design. Old and she is in business administration. Mountain climbing with a good book. Portugal is 25 years old and she has a degree in languages. She loves reading, cooking, and dancing. Rico. Puerto Rico is a 20-year-old model. She loves dancing and exercising. She specializes in American and English literature. She loves reading and writing. She is a student of communication and marketing. She loves surfing. Old and she is a student of business administration. She loves painting and playing the guitar. Ukraine is a 20-year-old beauty school teacher. She loves cooking, gardening, and fishing. United States of America. She is 19 years old and she is an ambassador for the United Nations. Venezuela is 22 years old and she does international trade. Her hobbies include modeling, reading, dancing, and traveling. Vietnam is 26 years old and she is a model and a master of ceremony. She loves traveling, reading, and listening to good music. Wales is 27 years old and she has a Bachelor's of Law degree.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are your top 20 contestants in their beautiful swimwear from MGI. Please give them a round of applause. Now, I would like to announce a very special award, Best in Swimsuit. And the Best in Swimsuit winner is Bahamas. Congratulations. Now, for another very exciting moment, we will announce the top 10 finalists. But before that, I'd like to announce the Miss Popular Vote title, which was voted on via our Miss Grand application. The Miss Popular Vote will pass directly into the top 10 finalists. And the Miss Popular Vote winner is Korea. Congratulations, you're the first one to make it into our top 10 finalists. Now, we have just 9 spots left. Are you ready? Next, to pass into the top 10 is Indonesia. Next, let's hear it for Peru. Next, hold them up, we have the Philippines. Next we have Ukraine. Let's show some love for the United States of America. Four spots left. One of them goes to Macau. Let's hear it for Bahamas. Two names left. Starting to get nervous here. Puerto Rico. Only one spot left in our top 10, and that will be claimed by Thailand. Congratulations, and keep the applause going for our top 10 finalists. Korea, Indonesia, Peru, Philippines, Ukraine, the United States of America, Macau, Bahamas, Puerto Rico, and Thailand. Keep the applause going, and we'll see you after the break.
Seeing like this, oh, it's very impressive to be here, you know, see that view.
Yeah, I know,
it's really big.
Yes.
great. That is so amazing, but I am so scary.
Brought to you by Blue Elephant Cooking School and Restaurant, G Herb Capsule One.
Bahamas.
As peacekeepers, it is our duty to promote love and unity. Wars exist in every area, on every level, from in-home violence which I have been subject to, drug wars, which I have been a part of, civil wars and clashes between nations. It is sad to see human beings care not that we are losing our brothers and sisters, our mothers, fathers, and children. We are losing our love, values, and respect for one another, thus causing us to not live in peace. We were created to reach out and touch the lives of those around us in a positive way. That means searching within ourselves and becoming the change that we would want to see in this world. Peace, freedom, and harmony should be within every nation, every religion, every race, every community, and every home. And although this grave infestation of war and violence seems unshakable, we must remember that no matter the country, we all belong to one race, the human race. And in understanding this, peace, love, and freedom can be imminent. Let's teach our children the act of freedom. For freedom, persons don't fear it for the sake of peace. The time is now to mute violence and showcase unity. For the only good thing about war is its ending. Thank you.
Indonesia.
War, suffering, death. These are the words that harm more than 30 million children victims of war. They suffer as a result of intolerance and wars around the world. I come from a military family. My father is an Indonesian military officer, so I have told since I was a child that war is destroying everything. The victims of war are suffering. Families are separated or killed. They don't have a safe place to live. They have to escape from death. I want to ask you one question. What are we fighting for and why? Please look at them. Look at the victims of war and the children. They lose their homes. They lose their parents. They lose their dreams. We should live in peace. So let's come together as one in unity. Let's come together to make this world a better place. Because I believe with the heart, sincerity, and hand in hand, we can give hope for them. And with the hope and work together, we can stop the war. So please, stop the war and choose peace. Thank you.
Korea.
Due to the conflict of the Cold War, since 1953, Korea was divided into South and North. When Korea was divided into two parts, a great number of people, including my grandmother, had to be separated from their family members. When they are separated from their family members, they cannot see their parents and children for more than 60 years, only praying to see their relatives again. War does not happen only between soldiers. The outcomes of the war is the agony of civilians and tears of our families and neighbors. So I ask you, let's set an example of unity and love from our school, families, and neighbors. And we should not be afraid to use our voice to stand up for justice. Thank you.
Macau.
In recent years, the world seems to have many tragedies, especially the terrorist attacks. In my heart, I always believe that there are two virtues that we need to continue to remind ourselves to improve, to develop. That's respect and empathy. If we put ourselves together and work on these two virtues, no war is necessary anymore. We could be proactive rather than reactive, and we will receive the most beautiful thing in the world. That's true and unconditional love. Thank you, Dr. Daga.
Peru.
All my life, I have dreamed to have the opportunity to give a message in front of millions of people. A message that can start change, a change that starts with me tonight. Showing language, religion, and ideas cannot limit us when finding peace. There are no excuses. Nothing will ever be worth more than a human life. Nothing will ever be justified that lose. We have the liberty to stop. We have the liberty to stop because this is dangerous or fear. But I can promise you, change will matter. It's not only about us anymore. It's about creating a world where people feel secure and respect, no matter where they stand. Peace starts with each of us. It's our decision. No excuses. Choose peace and start change. Thank you.
Philippines.
Good evening, everyone. Tonight, I will tell you a story about our world. One day, I was conducting a storytelling session in Tondo, which is an area in the Philippines where the poorest of the poor live. So I asked the kids to fold their papers into half, and then inside it, I asked them to draw who they want to be when they grow up and where they want to go, like a dream destination. But out of the 10 kids sitting on the floor, only 3 of them knew what they wanted to be when they grow up, and only 2 of them knew where they wanted to go. These kids, they do not need us to win wars for them. They need us to build a world for them that will allow them to grow, to dream, to live. Let's build a world where children do not have to wake up to the sound of bullets and bombs, where women and children do not have to face a battle the moment they take one step out of the door. I stand here tonight, refusing to tell the same story to our next generation. Children do not need to risk their lives in war for us. They need to fight for their dreams, not their lives. So I ask all of you tonight, let's all write a new book about our world and our common humanity, one that would finally give the next generation the happy ending they deserve. Good night.
Puerto Rico.
Dr. Martin Luther King said, "Darkness cannot put out darkness." This is a very beautiful phrase which conveys a very powerful message. The biggest changes in life are not accomplished by acts of violence, but having the willingness to do the things that inspires us and others, things that make us better. I truly believe the only way we can end war is living a life of peace and having tolerance. The Miss Grand International Organization is a vivid example of this philosophy. Bringing together 76 girls around the world to inspire the nations of the world. We need to believe that one kind act can become viral and change someone's life. That person can change a community. That community can change a country. And that country changed this world. We need to believe that we can actually do it, beginning with ourselves. Thank you.
Thailand.
When we talk about war and violence, of course, everybody don't want to hear that, and nobody need to let it happen. Some people lose their family, some people die, and some people, they have scars in their hearts forever, but no one can see. Because of the war and violence have never made anyone happy, just only can make lose in tears. I strongly believe Everyone can stop self-forgiveness with love and forgiveness to each other. I'm standing here tonight, so please, standing with me. And tell all of the voice into the world that we don't need war and violence, but we need love and forgiveness, kindness to each other. I hopefully believe all humans in the entire world can live peacefully, and we all can decrease the war and violence. Thank you. Khop khun kha.
Ukraine.
My country is suffering from war right now, and people die every day. We didn't start this war. We always been a peaceful country with peaceful people. We people who realize what is hopeless and helpless, and we still dream about peaceful sky and our country and all the world. Today I ask everybody what you can do for people who suffering hunger, war and violence. You must realize a little helpless can do make a big difference from war. Thank you.
The United States of America.
Sawadika. Speaking at the United Nations, I have met several people, people who are there, but yet do not share twice as much passion as we all share for this important cause. They are there, yet afraid to stand up for things such as gender equality, a better education, a better way of living for all of our people. But I am not afraid to stand up for this. They are there, but they are afraid. And that is why I believe that we must start at home. Parents must give their children a loving and understanding environment so that when they go out, they are not afraid to stand up for what they truly believe in. They are the future, but they can start now. Famine, racism, hate, when will it all end? Ban Ki-moon once said, "There is no plan B, because we do not have a planet B." And I say, stop the war and violence, finding peace through compassion. Khop khun kha.
For the last year, our Miss Grand International 2015 has handled a lot of duties. She's continued spreading out the Stop the War and Violence campaign by traveling around the world. Please, take a look.
I think as you grow older, you become acutely aware of certain moments that you can pinpoint as being truly life-changing. And these are the moments that define your vision of yourself and your choices for your future most poignantly. One of those life-changing moments was having the opportunity to visit the residents of Camp Hope, a camp set up for displaced earthquake victims in a local football field in Kathmandu, Nepal. They amazed me with their positivity, resilience, and adaptability in the face of such adversity. When I asked them how the earthquake had affected them and if it was hard living in the camp, their answer was truly humbling. They told me that in a way they were glad the earthquake had happened, because while it meant they had to leave their remote mountain village and relocate to Kathmandu, they now have access to a lot more resources and facilities, for which they are extremely grateful. A lot of them had never even been to school before, or even seen a big city. I've never been subject to the hardships or losses these children, and indeed a huge majority of the world, have to experience on a daily basis. I forget far too often to be thankful, mindful, and selfless. But to see the incredible fighting spirit and the appreciation of the small things in life displayed by those living in Camp Hope was so inspiring and reset in my mind what is truly important in life. I am so thankful to them for the precious moments we shared, for showing me some of the most amazing qualities of humanity, and for inspiring me to remember to remain positive, thankful, and kind-hearted always, in all ways.
Tonight, she will turn both her duty and crown over to the new Miss Grand International. Please welcome Claire Elizabeth Parker, Miss Grand International 2015.
Believe it, the time has finally come for me to say goodbye. What an amazing adventure this has been. You may not know that my name Claire is a French word which means light, and I have tried my best, not only during my term as Miss Grand International, but every day of my life, to be a complete embodiment of that word, light. To bring to light and raise awareness of the devastating effects of wars and violent acts. To be a beacon of light for those who have only known darkness. To be the light of hope in the hearts of those the world has forgotten. To be a guiding light and a shining example for those who will continue to follow in my footsteps to fight for the Stop the War and Violence campaign. To light up every room I enter and brighten the day of everyone that I meet. I would like to thank Mr. Nawat and the entire team of Miss Grand International for caring for me, supporting me, and believing in me, and for their leadership in fighting for a cause many do not have the courage to undertake. I would like to thank everyone that I've met during my travels and humanitarian work. Thank you for welcoming me into your communities, your homes, and your hearts. Thank you to the most important people in my life, my family, my friends, my mentors, for molding me into the woman I am proud to be today, and for loving me unconditionally and never letting me give up on my dreams. And finally, thank you to all of you, all my fans around the world, for always cheering for me, putting a smile on my face, and loving me like a friend. I hope you will continue to support me in whatever the future may hold. I hope that from this day forward, I can continue to shine my light to guide the next Miss Grand International as I pass on the responsibility and the honor of changing the world. I hope that even though tonight I'm closing this chapter in my life, I will always remain in your memories and in your hearts. And so, for the very last time, Claire Elizabeth Parker, Miss Grand International 2015! Gentlemen, at this moment, please join me in welcoming to the stage Mr. Nawat Itzara Gracil, the president of Miss Grand International.
you, Mr. Nawat Itzara Gracie, president of Miss Grand International. And Claire Elizabeth Parker, Miss Grand International 2015.
Of me.
ladies and gentlemen, here are your top 10. Very, very beautiful. In fact, I need to take advantage of my hosting position and get a little closer to these ladies, ask some questions. Hello.
Hello, how are you?
I'm well, how are you feeling?
I'm feeling a little happy, excited, nervous, anxious, all in one.
Well, take a deep breath, you've made it this far. What would you say has been the most difficult part of this journey?
Difficult part is I have to compete myself every day. I'm trying not to compare myself with other girls because there are so many beautiful girls here. Yes.
These are some wise women, folks. Now, we are ready to announce our top five. I'm getting nervous and I'm not even competing, folks. All right, our first spot in the top five goes to Puerto Rico. Next, let's hear it for the United States of America. I've learned my lesson. I don't even need to tell you to make some noise. Philippines. Ladies and gentlemen, we have only two spots left. Let's show your love for Thailand. Ladies and gentlemen, there is only one last name on this card, and that name is Indonesia. Congratulations to all of you stunning ladies. Coming up next is our final question. One of the most important parts in deciding who will be the next Miss Grand International 2016. Coming up right after the break.
Brought to you by Nusa Siri, AJ Music Box. The winner will be crowned Miss Grand International 2016 Golden Crown and get a 1 year free residence by the Up Akamai Condominium by Nusa Siri throughout her missions.
Welcome back to the Miss Grand International 2016 World Final, live from Westgate International Theater in Las Vegas, Nevada, USA. Now, finally, we've got our top five finalists. Is everybody ready to meet them? Come on now, I know we can make more noise in this room. Is everybody ready to meet them? All right now, please welcome to the stage the top five finalists of Miss Grand International 2016 for their final walk.
When I wake up to your footsteps as you get up out of bed, they make a song that sounds so simple, but it dances in my head. A melody so perfect that it gets me through the day. And the thought of us forever is one that won't ever go away. All I need to know is where to start. Take my hand and show me forever side. Never will I ever let you go. Let's write a story and let's sing a song. Let's hang our pictures on the wall. All these precious moments that we carved in stone are only memories after all. Memories after all. Memories after all. And oh, you gave me hope, but I've got.
Don't they look absolutely amazing in their gowns? Now, we will continue to the final question, an opportunity for the girls to show their problem solving and public speaking skills. Now, we only have one question for all of you. You'll be able to hear each contestant answer during the final question round. And you will all answer the question in the order of your final walk. The final question is... Wow. Yeah, stop the music. This is not easy. If you had to choose one of these two people to help you stop the war and violence, who would you choose between Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton? And why? I'll read that one more time, because I want to give you ladies some time to think. If you had to choose one of these two people help you to stop the war and violence, who would you choose between Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton, and why? Let's start with Puerto Rico.
If I had to choose one person, I would choose Hillary Clinton. She has dedicated her whole life for this cause. I believe in girl power. I am here today representing women around the world. I am diversity, and I believe she embodies those qualities. I think she would be the amazing woman president for the first time in the United States of America. So I choose Hillary Clinton. Thank you.
Next, United States of America.
Good evening, everyone. Believe it or not, I would choose Donald Trump. Why? Because the same way that we are all here to change the minds of people, to share our passion of stop the war and violence, it's the same way I will share my passion with him. And the same power that he has to stand up for what he believes in is how I will have him stand up for stop the war and violence and change the lives of people together. Thank you.
Next, let us hear from Philippines.
Okay, you have to promise me that you would react after my first sentence. I would choose Donald Trump to stop the war and violence with me, because if we choose him to switch to our side, there won't be war and violence anymore. So I will also make sure that he will read my speeches to stop the war and violence, because imagine someone who would bring so much madness and so much emotion from these people. What if we use his voice to actually do good for the world? What if we use that to our advantage? So, that's why let's keep the peace and let Donald Trump switch to our side to stop the war and violence.
Next, we'll hear from Thailand.
Of course, if I can shoot one, for sure, I will shoot Madam Clinton. Because she's a lady as same as me. Also, I can work with her, and she's so kind and friendly. And the most important, she is in my inspiration. And also, I love her. Thank you. Cảm ơn.
Indonesia.
So it's a very hard question for me, but I will choose. If I have a chance to choose, I will choose Hillary Clinton. Yeah! Why? because I know she's a very smart woman, independent woman, and brave woman. That's why I will choose her to work together with me. And I believe if I and Madam Clinton work together, I believe I can stop the war. And I ask the people to join with us to stop the war and violence. So I choose her to work together with me to stop the war and violence. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, these are the answers from our top five finalists for Miss Grand International 2016. Now, I wish all of you luck for tonight, but unfortunately, only one can win the title of Miss Grand International 2016. Now, next break, we'll have a big surprise for everyone in the room, and you will know who will be the next Miss Grand International 2016. So please, don't go away.
Brought to you by MGI Swimwear.
Welcome back to Miss Grand International 2016, live from Westgate International Theater in Las Vegas, Nevada, USA. Now this is the most exciting moment of the entire evening. By the way, before we announce the result of who will win Miss Grand International 2016, we have a really big surprise. We'd like to announce the host country for Miss Grand International 2017. Which country do you think it is? What are you thinking at home? What country was that? Let's take a look. Very wonderful place, Vietnam. And it's a very beautiful country, and we are proud to call them our host country. Now, the location, the culture, and the people will make for a great Miss Grand International 2017. I hope to see you all there. The world finale for that night will be October 25th, 2017. And I thank you again to the host country, Vietnam. Now, for the very exciting moment, I will announce the special title awards. The next special award is for Best Social Media. And the Best Social Media award goes to Jamaica. our last special award is for the best in evening gown. And the award goes to England. Okay, now, it's time for the most exciting moment for the entire evening. We will announce the final results. The fourth runner-up is the United States of America. Our third runner-up is Puerto Rico. And our second runner-up is Thailand. Ladies and gentlemen, I think you know what this means. There are only two contestants left, Indonesia and Philippines. We're at the final moment, the biggest moment of the entire evening. Here we go. Are you both breathing still?
No, I can't.
My lung is at half capacity.
All right, ladies, here we go. Are you ready? And Miss Grand International 2016 is Indonesia. Now this means if for any reason the new Miss Grand International cannot fulfill her duties, the first runner-up will come forward and complete her role as Miss Grand National. Congratulations to Miss Indonesia. Give a round of applause, people. Let's show some love. Don't go anywhere yet. Your public wants to hear from you. How are you feeling right now?
I don't know. I feel nervous.
Just breathe. Just breathe.
Yes.
All right.
Breathe.
So what do you want to say to your millions of fans watching right now all over the world?
I just want to say thank you. Thank you very much, all my fans, all my supporters, my family. Thank you very much for you all. You guys are the best.
Are you ready to travel the world and change the world as Miss Grand International?
Yes, of course. I'm ready to work together with Miss Grand International Organization to stop the war of violence. And I just want to say thank you for Mr. Nawat. Thank you for all the judges. Thank you for all everyone. Thank you so much. Indonesia, we did it.
What a good night. You may now take your first walk as Miss Grand International 2016. Please, ladies and gentlemen, give her a round of applause. Give our Miss Grand International 2016 a round of applause. I hope everyone enjoyed the night. I look forward to seeing you in Vietnam on October 25th, 2017. Thank you again to all of our beautiful participants and to all of our fans watching. Have a wonderful night.
The thought of us forever is one that won't ever go away. All I need to know is where to stop. Take my hand and show me forever side. Let's write a story and let's sing a song. Let's hang our pictures on the wall. All these precious moments that we carved in I've gotta let go.